Hi, good afternoon. I'm Joy Thomas Moore. I am, nowadays I'm pretty much known as the mother of Westmore. But my greater claim to fame is that I'm a friend of Joe and CFUF. I was a single mom. I have three children. Wes is the middle and the only boy. My husband died when Wes was 3, and my oldest was about 10, and my youngest was about a year and a half. Suddenly, it was 24 hours he was gone, so we didn't have any time to think about, okay, what would life be like with only one parent around? Fortunately, we had a really strong relationship, and throughout my time raising the kids, I always felt that I could say, what would Wes do? His name was Wes as well. And so in a way, I sort of felt I was a single mom, but I felt like I was a parent with a strong connection to my husband and to the kid's dad. I don't know how many of you have read Wes's book, The Other Westmore, but he talks about the other Wes, and there's a part in the book where the two of them are talking in prison, and the other Wes, my Wes, said, you know, so tell me, you know, how do you feel that the fact that your dad wasn't there had an impact on you? And the other Wes, as a tribute to how intelligent this guy is and what a wasted effort he is having to spend the rest of his life in prison, and had we as a community gotten around him when he was 12, that he wouldn't be spending the rest of his life in prison, and we wouldn't be spending something like $4 million if he lives to 78, which is about the average age of black men. We are now going to spend $4 million keeping him in prison, and this man should be out here being a part of our community. But Wes said, you know, your dad wasn't there because he couldn't be there. My dad wasn't there because he chose not to be there. Therefore, we are going to mourn their loss in different ways. And I think that is a big part of what's going on in our communities. And because of organizations like the center, I think we have a chance to turn that around, as we were talking about before.
Good afternoon. My name is Gary Davis. I'm a father of graduate of the trial program is located here in the Center for Urban Family Building. I'm a member of the Responsible College Program also.
I'm a father of 5, graduated high school, but decided to get into the street life a little bit. What comes with that is a background. And my issue today is talking about jobs and background, criminal background.
Good afternoon. My name is Anyana Johnson. Single mother, and I have 3 children and an adopted child. I also would like to say I too am in trouble. I didn't have the greatest upbringing. I am in recovery. I have 13 years clean from crack cocaine. Able to forgive him. He did the best he could with what he had. And I was also able to ask him to forgive me for the anger. I did the best I could with what I had. raising one of 22 grandchildren. My son's oldest child. It's not easy. Even though I came from such a hard background, I woke up one day and decided it was enough. It was time to get my life together. So I'm now in school getting my A degree in ministry. I'm studying to be a teacher.
So we're going to begin with the most basic question and then work to some very specifics. Families, about relationships, choices that we make, things to be involved in, and how not only does it impact our community, but impact our children, impact our home. Can someone give me some water? There's some bottled water in the room. Okay.
Excuse me,
so the first question, what do you think is the most important issue facing, the most important challenge facing the Black family today? What is the most important issue? Why do you think it's the most important issue? If we were to address that issue, could we begin to change some of the dynamics? What do you think is the most important, critical issue facing the Black family today? We'll start with this one.
I think I've always sort of, guess I'm a real Democrat because I, you know, can never say one or the other, but I think it is the fact of the fatherlessness, because I think out of that comes so many other issues. I mean, I think a man, one thing Wes always says is that he couldn't, anything that I did was great and fine, but I could not teach him to be a man. And you need to model that behavior. And if a man's not there going to work every day, if a man's not there being nice to or being supportive of the mother, how does a young man learn that? So I think it starts there, and then all the other things sort of flow from that.
Mr. Vince. The absentees of the fathers. A lot of these fathers out here, they really have bad decisions, and they wind up in jail, and they need someone else to raise their kids. That's why a lot of these families are Black families. What do you think is the most important, what's the critical issue facing on challenging the Black family today?
The same. Like, the fathers with the guidance from the fathers, guidance from the mother. Like, I had my mother there for all my life, but I ain't had my father. And I really think if I had, like, that male figure, that male guidance there, I don't think, even though I graduated high school, but still, the choices in life that I made, I don't think I've made those choices.